Hi Gemini, I'm here to do your end of July general reading. Let me just start off by saying that I'm sorry. It took me a while to release your guys' videos. I've been really sick. I had food poisoning and I was just like dead for 3 days. I literally died and resurrected. Resurrected on this freaking eclipse, on the eclipse day, right? Like, hello, go figure. Either that or I'm going through a fucking transformation, but damn, that shit was crucial. I thought I was gonna die. It was horrible. So sorry, I'm here now. Hallelujah, I'm still alive. You still have your reader, so let's get started. All right, so I'm gonna start with the Emperor reversed, with the Ace of Cups reversed, and the Ten of Wands reversed. I'm feeling that some of you are dealing with a fire sign, an Aries maybe. I'm getting strong Aries vibes. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, but I'm strong Aries vibes, where you weren't happy with them, okay? You weren't happy, maybe your boss, maybe this could be a boss, this could be, anybody that you were not happy with. You dropped the wands, you're like, I am not going to be burdened by this motherfucker, because the Emperor reversed to me is a motherfucker. Is a fucking asshole. I'm sorry, but not, he's an asshole. So the love was not there, okay? No feelings, all cold, and you're just like, I'm done. I'm seeing you just let this fire sign go. Some of you let a fire sign go, okay? We do have the King of Wands here, so this is more fire energy, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Then we have the Knight of Swords reverse. So it's like this fire sign was not being honest with you. They didn't come forward with how they truly felt, and that's why you had to let it go. You had to walk away. Or someone wasn't being honest with you. They didn't give you truth or clarity, okay? Right next to that, we have the King of Swords reversed. So either you weren't being honest with somebody, or somebody wasn't being honest with you. There's some kind of communication that needs to come in, but you're refusing to communicate to anybody because there's something that you're going through. Because we also have Temperance reversed with the Death card. The Death card signifies transformation, okay? Temperance really talks about, you could be dealing with the Sagittarius or even a Scorpio or Capricorn, whatever, because we have a little bit of everything. But you could be going through a major transformation where you're letting shit die out. You're learning your karmic lessons. Some of you are learning your karmic lessons. You're letting go of people, places, things that no longer serve you. Okay? With the Temperance reverse, though, that's what really gets me, because some of you really need to work on your physical selves, your spirituality. And maybe you will be pretty soon. Okay, because the Death card is talking about transformation, going through an awakening, or going through something major that really shook you up and just forced you to turn to spirituality, or turn to, readers like me, and then to find inspiration and answers and stuff like that. But with the Temperance, it's like you need to really take better care of yourself, physically, emotionally. Okay, and I know that you guys are in, like, some of you are resting from all the trauma that you've been through. Okay, there's good news, I promise you. Hold on. Like I said, some of you let go of a fire sign, then others of you let go of an earth sign, Capricorn, Taurus, or Virgo. Okay, this, because we have the Devil reverse, and this could be you being bound to somebody in the upright and shit. So in reverse, it's like you let go of toxic situations. You freed yourself from that. Could be a Capricorn that you let go of. You freed yourself from that person. They constantly left you feeling like you were left out in the cold. Okay? You're healing, like I said, because Three of Swords in reverse is really healing. And then the Ten of Cups reverse. So this per you had to let go of this person. Or situation that you were bound to. It was a really hurtful process. Some of you were, it could be addictions, codependency, a person, a job that you were really bound to, and you just, like, you weren't happy and you had to let go finally. Okay, so it was really hard for you to do that. That transition was not easy, but you did it. You got through it. Some of you did it and you got fucking through it. So Now I'm seeing here with the Seven of Wands reverse. It's like you don't have to be on your constant guard anymore. You let your guard down. You can rest. You can take a breather now. You're like, fuck, finally, you know? And above that, well, not above that. Where is it at? Oh, Three of Pentacles with the Four of Pentacles. It's like you're working now. You're working hard and you're holding tightly to what you have now. Because you don't want to lose it, whether that's being by yourself, living on your own, having a better situation. Okay, you're holding tightly to it. Some of you are saving, working hard and saving money so that you can go out and go on a vacation or save for something great and good finally. Versus before you couldn't do that because you were dealing with fuckery and you were just, you know, bound to shit. Okay. The High Priestess reverse here is telling me that some of you are not following your intuition. You guys are not listening to the voice within when it's telling you something. Like, the universe has its way of communicating with you, whether that's through numbers or songs. You could be thinking about something and then someone says something to answer that on the TV or the radio or whatever. And you're like, oh shit, that's crazy. But then you let it go. You don't really think about it. You don't really look deep into it. Okay, because a lot of you are not, you know, awakened in that way. But I'm seeing now you're going to be paying attention more about it because, you know, of the other cards that I have here, which I'll tell you right now. With the High Priestess reversed, this could also mean that you weren't being honest with yourself either. Okay, you could be saying, I don't need nobody in my life. I'm good how I am now. I dropped and left a certain situation so that I could be happier. And blah, blah, blah. But deep down inside, you do want that. You do want a better situation, a better outcome, whether that's expanding your family or rising higher in your career, going back to school or whatever it is. Because with the Four of Cups here, to me, this looks like you're missing. You're waiting. When is it my time? You know, what's next? Okay. So we have the Lover's card, and this is you. This is Gemini. This could either mean an actual lover's coming in, or this could talk about a choice, a major choice that you have to make. Okay? Underneath that, we have the Two of Cups. Okay? Maybe a lover is going to come in. Okay? You see that full moon there? Full moon, new moon, eclipse, whatever. Time for loving, new beginnings. We have the Four of Wands. This is the Love 1111 card. Finding your twin flame. Being happily ever after all this hell you went through. When is that going to happen? Because you're wondering when it's going to happen. Dreaming about it. What's going to be like when I find my true love or that perfect job or career? Well, I can't tell you because the cards can't either. You have the Unknown card. Sorry! Wah, wah, wah. It's not time for you to know. There's certain things that we're able to see and interpret, but other times it's like, you know what? It's best that you don't know. Because if you know, you might want to speed it up, fuck up the process, the natural flow, and then it don't fucking happen. So there you go, Idaho. I'm going to pull an oracle for you really quick. So, don't worry. Good things are coming. You're going through a transformation, okay? Just take better care of yourself. Don't put yourself out there in a sense where, like, you felt like you were locked up at one point or you couldn't do anything because, you know, you were dealing with that devil card, that bad situation where you weren't happy and shit in. Okay, better things are coming. I'm also seeing that maybe another fire sign is going to really say, some of you are dealing with someone who's like saying things and then they don't end up doing it. Like, oh, I want to do this, I want to do that. They're all talking, no action. So be careful with people like that. Okay. We have Explore Your Options and Blessed Change, you see? So, It's time to look at other possibilities. It's a good time to make changes. Yes, it is. Especially with that death card, it's talking about change. Major changes are going to be happening. Okay? It's blessed change. It's going to be a blessed change. A major life change brings you great blessings. Hello, we have like the two best cards here. Two of Cups and the freaking Four of Wands. Whether this is love finally, after being in a nightmare, or better job, a better career, versus being stuck with somebody or something where you're just felt like it was eternal hell. Yeah, there's good things coming. Sometimes we have to go through that so that we can appreciate the bomb shit that comes to us right after. Okay, after rainbow comes a storm. All right, Geminis, this was your end of July general messages. Let me know in the comments below if it resonated. Please take note this is general, so it may or may not. That's what private readings are for. And I will see you guys in my next video. Love ya. Bye.